Did you know that decades of research have actually found that one of the best predictors of adult success is whether or not they did chores in childhood? Now, keyword is one of the best predictors, okay? Not the only predictor. But I am a huge fan of chores and starting them early. So in today's video, I'm gonna share some more benefits of doing chores, and I will also share some simple chore ideas for toddlers all the way through preschoolers. So let's get into it. So the first huge benefit of chores is that since they're working towards something, when they finish the chore, they have a great sense of accomplishment and feeling like they're competent and they can do things. And so that is going to in turn increase their self-esteem. Chores also help with teaching them life skills, also responsibility, and really respect, right? They're more likely going to respect all of our hard work that we do around the house to keep everything clean if they're a part of that process as well and they know how much work goes into it. Chores help with their work ethic. They teach responsibility. It also is a great way to connect with your child, right? These can be opportunities to connect and bond with your child, right? We can kind of, change our perspective of chores. And make it like it's just a daily routine, just like we eat, just like we sleep, just like we play. We also, help out around the house. And this can be a time that we connect and we spend time with each other and we have fun. I mean, chores can be fun. If we set that stage for them. So along those same lines, the best way that children are going to learn is through our modeling. Okay, so that's where we want to start, especially if we have a little one. We're going to start by modeling what it looks like to, clean up our messes and put away our toys and all that kind of good stuff. Okay, so you're going to start with modeling it for them. Then you're going to invite them to join you as you're cleaning, and use a lot of praise to get them going, get them more motivated, help with that connection between you guys. And then the third step is to invite them to do it independently. And then you're just there observing, supervising, and cheering them along the way. Okay, so let's get into some simple chore ideas that you can start with your toddlers. So I think you can start this process as soon as they are walking and they're able to pick up things, okay? So they're gonna need a lot of guidance with this in the beginning, of course, right? And a lot of modeling, like I just mentioned, but they can do something as simple as picking up a piece of trash and bringing it to the trash can, and you can guide them through this. So the first step might be to walk them over to the trash, point to it, tell them pick it up please, or pick up trash please. They pick it up, you can carry them or you can guide them or hold their hand as you guys walk to the trash can. You can open the trash can for them and point again. Use a lot of point and visual cues to say, okay, drop it in the trash. And then you get super excited. Yay! Good job throwing away the trash. I really appreciate your help around here. You are such an awesome helper. Whatever you want to say to kind of increase their self-esteem, their motivation. Again, y'all, toddlers love to be helpers, and this is actually helping with their self-esteem, their sense of responsibility and purpose in the family, okay? So start there. Start with having them pick up trash, or the same kind of process can be applied if they need to pick up a toy and put it somewhere, put it in a play bin or put it on the shelf or wherever. So again, you're guiding them through this. This is not done out of anger. They're not in trouble. This is fun, okay? So be mindful that we are setting the stage for their views of chores. And if we come at it like, this is fun, this is play, this is just what we do, versus,
okay, you're in trouble, you threw that trash on the floor, go pick it up, or
whatever, then they're gonna have a different perspective. So be mindful of your energy through this process, and we are guiding them. So for the young toddlers, they can pick up trash, they can pick up their toys and put them away. They can help feed the pet, So you can, again, guide them through this process, but you can get them involved in scooping up the dry food, or you can scoop it up for them and just invite them to pour the dry food in the bowl, or you can do that whole process, but have them walk the bowl, you know, to the place where your pet eats. Whatever, part you want to get them involved in is fine. You'll want to be mindful of their certain abilities when it comes to these things and just kind of follow their lead and use a lot of guiding and modeling throughout this process. One of the first chores that we got our little ones to start doing is after bath time, we would tuck our toys in to their bag. So they would put all of their toys into, we have like a netted bag, and after bath time, before they were allowed to get out, we'd say, okay, it's time to tuck in your toys, put them away, they're ready for bed. Get them ready for bed, get them all comfy, so that it kind of made sense and it was a little motivating for them. But that's something that we did every time after bath time, and it's just like a little ritual that we started when it came to chores. Okay, so let's talk about preschoolers. So that's between 3 and 5. They can help with rinsing off plastic plates and utensils after they're done eating. They can help with unloading the dishwasher and helping with organize the different utensils, as long as they're plastic, of course, and can't get hurt. They can also help with making their bed and pulling weeds, and again, gardening, helping you with watering the plants. They love to do those types of things. So although I included some age ranges of some, you know, types of chores that your child may be able to do, it's always important to keep your individual child in mind. Every child is unique in their abilities and their skills. So of course, if some of these things your child is not able to do at this moment, don't worry. Just sort of, again, help with modeling for them, guiding them through this process, and making sure that keeping in mind the energy that you're bringing and keeping this very upbeat, light, and fun. Turn on some music and have fun. Use this as a connecting time. So I'll be sharing my views on allowance, since I get this question a lot. I'll also be sharing some extra tips on how to motivate your child to do their chores. So make sure you're subscribed to my channel so you don't miss out on those videos. Be sure to watch this video next. It's all about how to get your child to listen to you. And I also include some chore related instructions that I think will be helpful for you guys. All right, I'll see you in the next one. Bye.